that I sent you is broadcast out to a global network of millions of computers, each using the highest level of cryptography. And all around the world is a group of people called miners, not young people, like gold miners. And these miners have massive computing power estimated to be 20 to 50 times bigger than Google in the world, biggest computing resource in the world. And the miners do a lot of work to validate that transaction. And every 10 minutes, sort of like the heartbeat of a network, a block gets created. And that block contains all the transactions from the last 10 minutes. The fact that I sent you $1,000, but it could be the two people bought, sold stock, or got married, or someone registered a land title, or some light bulb bought some power from a distributed power source. It could be anything, ultimately. And then the miners use this computing power, and they compete to validate the block. And the winning miner gets paid some of the cryptocurrency from that blockchain. And then, this is the important part, that block is connected to the previous block with a digital wax seal. And it's only valid if it references the previous block. So if I wanted to hack that block and take that $1,000 and send it to everybody in this room to commit fraud, I'd have to hack that block plus the previous block, the entire history of Congress, not just on one computer, but across millions of computers simultaneously, all using the highest level of cryptography while the most powerful computer resource in the world is watching me to make sure I don't mess around. Now, I'm not gonna say that's unhackable, but it's tough to do. Now, I used an analogy to describe this that I'm a little gun shy now because late night television had some fun with it. You may know John Oliver. He did a whole half-hour show on blockchain.
And because of the complicated process the network uses to verify records, it is very secure. Now relax, I'm not gonna get into what that process is or how it works, but I will share a really helpful, really dumb metaphor for why it is safe.
The way I like to think of it is that a blockchain is a highly processed thing, sort of like a chicken McNugget. And if you wanted to hack it, it'd be like turning a chicken McNugget back into a chicken. Now someday someone will be able to do that.
Hold on, that is an absolutely horrible thought. So why is that reporter so happy about the idea? Because if anyone ever figures out how to turn a chicken McNugget back into a chicken, that chicken is going to be fucked up. Haunting poetry about the experience, the things I saw, but bacaw. My body is whole, but what of my soul?
My body is whole, but what of my soul? So, the hype machine has begun. It's on late night TV. The Economist did a cover story saying a blockchain was not just comparable to the first era of the internet, but comparable to the creation of double entry accounting, which was the foundation of the corporation. And now Dilbert's involved, and if Dilbert is involved, you know big time that this has really gone mainstream. So I got lucky. My son Alex was an investment banker, and the two of us came together over a father and son ski trip a little over 4 years ago, and we started sharing notes. We decided to work together, and we wrote the book, Blockchain Revolution, and I'm thankful this is the big bestseller on the topic, and announced today, June 12th, a new edition comes out with 25,000 new words. Now, you're probably wondering how to get this in pre-order. Go on to Amazon and order